The Flipper Zero just got a huge upgrade. New powers, new functions for the command line interface, and even mouse control. Firmware 1.3.4 is here, and if you need to know what's inside, it's happening after the intro. Hi, I'm Sandy from Lab401.com. Today we're taking a look at the latest official firmware update of the Flipper Zero version 1.3.4. This release is packed with significant changes, so we'll be breaking down the exciting new features, the crucial improvements, and the important bug fixes. Let's get started. First up, the Dolphin gets some new animations, including a parkour move and a Doom-inspired tribute. If you're experimenting with BadUSB scripts, version 1.3.4 now adds basic mouse movement commands. It's not full pointer control yet, but you can now move the cursor alongside keyboard actions. This opens new options for HID payloads beyond just typing. New sub-GHz and low-frequency RFID protocols. This update adds support for the Noralsy format in LFRFID and a 42-bit variant of the Prastel protocol in sub-GHz. NFC enhancements. Support for reading and analyzing DESFire cards with transaction MAC file types. A new API for FeliCa cards to read specific blocks using service codes. CLI loading external commands. The command line interface now supports loading external command modules straight from the SD card, running directly without needing a firmware reflash. This makes the CLI way more powerful and flexible. Documentation updates. New guides were added, like getting started with JavaScript and updated docs for the storage module. Smart auto-completion. Hit Tab and it helps complete your commands. And support for modern control sequences. Behind the scenes, the architecture and API were reworked as well. It is making everything faster, more stable, and more powerful. Support for common NFC types, like FeliCa, MIFARE DESFire, and MIFARE Classic, is now more reliable for reading, writing, and emulation. Bluetooth Low Energy sees solid upgrades. Better support for custom profiles and advertising modes. A bigger internal stack for more stable HID connections. A slight increase to the manufacturer-specific data size, or MSD size, allowed in BLE ads. Memory management got smarter, freeing up more RAM for apps and optimizing the heap system. The infrared remote database was updated. Expect better matching and support for more TVs, AC units, and other devices. JavaScript engine improvements. Internal updates improve memory usage and add value destructuring syntax, making app development cleaner and more efficient. Reading files from the SD card, like keys, assets, and dictionaries, is now faster and smoother. You can now pin your favorite settings right to the top of the menu for quicker access. Flipper Zero Firmware 1.3.4 also delivers key bug fixes, including restored 5-volt output on GPIO pins, fixed infrared sending issues, solved a crash when saving certain NFC tags, improved low-frequency RFID tag detection between Noralsy and SecuraKey, and of course overall stability boosts across the board. Before I go, a huge shout out to all the new contributors. Your work powers all these awesome updates. If this video helped you out, please do me a favor and hit that like button. It really supports the channel. And make sure you subscribe to Lab401 for more Flipper Zero content, pentesting hardware reviews, and tutorials. Of course, head over Lab401.com, the official distributor of the Flipper Zero, where you'll find the device itself, cases, screen protectors, and accessories. While you're here, check out our curated collection of pentesting tools, always with the best service and the best price. Take care, and see you next time.